Today I presented data, a sub-study from the Odyssey Outcomes Trial. The Odyssey Outcomes Trial is a huge trial in almost 19,000 post-acute coronary syndrome patients. And they were randomized to alirocumab, PCSK9 inhibitor or placebo. And the interesting thing is they were already well treated, so they received their cholesterol lowering medication as they should have by the guidelines. So they were all intensive statin therapy, and on top of that they got additional cholesterol lowering medication, alirocumab, which lowers your LDL cholesterol by another 60%. And yeah, you could easily argue for daily practice, is this really necessary? Will this be really helpful? Is it worth the issue? And of course, in the main results, we showed that in general, additional LDL lowering, if you do not meet your goals, yes, it is of clearly added value. It lowers your future risk of cardiac events, but it even reduces your future risk of death. Having said that, you're always looking for patients where this new type of medication is working optimally, and that you could try to identify these people with extra high risk, which would also qualify for more medication and have additional gain. And you could do this in a very complex way with very complex scores. You add this and then that, and if this, but you could also look at easy to recognize patient characteristics, and we did that today as we presented by looking at the patient and does he have only coronary disease or has he also atherosclerotic disease somewhere else? Easy to recognize, so peripheral artery disease, or did he suffer from cerebral vascular disease, like he had suffered from a stroke or TIA or carotid disease. Everybody knows that, so it doesn't need complex testing. You can just ask your patient, did you suffer from a stroke? Do you have pain in your legs with walking? And today we clearly showed that if you have more than one vascular bed, so more than only coronary, but you have also in two vascular beds, so in your legs and in your heart, or in your legs and your heart and your head, that your risk goes up tremendously. And for those patients, actually, it also is clear that if you lower your cholesterol additionally, if you're not on target, it helps a lot. So your baseline risk in this type of patients with multivascular disease, polyvascular disease, is much higher, but what you gain is also much more. So it's a very easily recognizable group that you can easily treat more optimally or better.